As an overview and a preview to the course, we will now discuss how two general processes operate on and in the Earth. These are the external and the internal processes. The external processes wear the Earth down and include erosion, rivers, waves, wind, groundwater, glaciers. Think of mountains when you think of these processes. The Arbuckle Mountains in southern Oklahoma along Interstate 35, they're fairly small mountains. Compare those with the Rocky Mountains just west of Denver. Much larger, higher mountains. Why is there a difference? Well, the Arbuckle Mountains are 300 million years old. There's been a lot more time for those external processes to wear them down. The Rocky Mountains are maybe 20 million years old, so much less time. So what controls these external processes? It's called the hydrologic or the water cycle. And what is it? Well, when rain or snow falls on the Earth, the water, it eventually moves to the oceans where you get evaporation. You put moisture back in the atmosphere. That moisture then causes precipitation back on the land. That is the hydrologic or the water cycle. Now I have an assignment for you for our next class. I'd like you to research what actually controls the hydrologic cycle and be prepared to discuss that in class. Now for the internal processes. These are the processes that build up the Earth and include volcanoes, earthquakes, and mountain building. What is the control? It's something called plate tectonics, which is a relatively new theory. Maybe you've heard about a gentleman named Wegener who proposed in the early 1900s that the continents had actually drifted across the globe. He based that on the jigsaw puzzle fit of the continents and proposed that at one time all the continents were together. Well, his theory was not well accepted, and it wasn't until the 1950s or 60s that new evidence was presented that convinced a lot of geologists that plate tectonics is a valid hypothesis and it is now a theory. And this theory of plate tectonics basically states that interactions between these moving plates on the globe cause all kinds of interesting things such as earthquakes, mountain building, and volcanism. So I have another assignment for you. What drives these tectonic processes? I'll provide one hint. It involves heat.